Welcome to a new video of the Parts channel. Well, I'm going to make a short video answering a question that you have left me. Can you drive with the vehicle with a MAF sensor or flow meter disconnected? Let's see. Many vehicles ask you they will allow you to circulate with this piece disconnected, since the AQ, if it detects that this piece is not there, because the connector has been removed, it will use the parameters that it has preset from the factory. It has some values and it will use them to think that the vehicle, when it mixes fuel and air, not only uses the data that the flow meter or MAF sensor gives it, it also uses the data that the MAF sensor gives it, it uses the data that the TPS gives it, to know the opening the throttle. Okay, or use the potentiometer, the data from the potentiometer, the accelerator pedal, the oxygen sensor, etc., etc. Okay, then of course, there are vehicles that if you've been with this for a while, let's see, I advise you to simply unplug it to test. If this part fails, you know, when the flow meter fails, the failures it usually gives is normally, the vehicle does not go as it should, or it is accelerated, or it is burning a lot of fuel, and that is why you see a lot of black smoke, or the idle speed is unstable. Okay, then of course, if you remove the connector by taking the values that it has presets, the vehicle will go better. But the problem is that if it has been disconnected for a long time, that is why I'm simply saying this test to verify that it is a fault and change it. Okay, if it has been disconnected for a long time, there are vehicles that still do not show any fault in the panel. It does not limit the vehicle or anything. But there will be another vehicles that you get an engine fault, that the vehicle will be limited, that you disconnect the turbo, that the anti-pollution system fails, etc., etc. Okay. For that reason, my advice is that you have this part connected, because as I say, the AQ will have the most exact values if the piece is in conditions, better than the values that it has, let's say, it, which is the serial AQ, because of course, if this piece apart from giving the values of the mass of air that enters, it also gives the temperature, to know the density of that air, because it is not the same that you circulate at sea level, to that you circulate at 3000 meters high, for example. Okay, then it will always go better with the flow meter in good condition than with the flow meter disconnected. Okay, for this reason, my advice is that you always have it connected. There are those who say, no, it is that the flow meter was disconnected and the car is running better. But that may be because the ECU is, when using the values that they have by default, well, it does a rich mixture, and then it seems that the vehicle has more power, or it could be the other way around, that there is a lean mixture and the vehicle is worse. Okay, but as I say this part, I is there for a reason. My advice is not to have it disconnected. Okay, I know people who where it disconnects gives in their vehicles. I also say yes, but I also advise them not to do it. But each one does what they want with their car, right? Well, here you have this video. If it has been of utility, because do not forget to give a like and subscribe to the channel.